The economy and infrastructure public hearing for the inquiry into the use of school buses in rural and regional Victoria continues.
From a policy point of view, we treat the bus as if it's like being on school grounds.
Public transport during COVID right now is down to 13% of baseline levels. Bus is still at 25% in metro and 30% in regional.
If we're making these buses available at different times outside of the 2 hours allocated in the morning and the two in the afternoon for other services, are we basically then talking about a scenario where there's a cost involved that's not necessarily recoverable?
You would be considering about a fee for service that would lessen the subsidy required from government, but you'd then be weighing up its contribution to the overall public transport effort in terms of accessibility.
We're also advised that the buses may not meet code when it comes to access for the disabled.
I understand it is an issue that just with the sort of both the bus stop design and the quality of the shoulder and curb on country roads, that there are technical difficulties in being able to run fully disability compliant buses everywhere.
In regional and rural Victoria, often the school bus stop is a piece of gravel. To make the infrastructure compliant would be astronomical, I would imagine.
It would be well in excess of what we put in as an annual subsidy into overall buses per annum. So the capital costs alone would be huge, yeah.
Children access public transport in metropolitan areas, and I don't think everybody boarding the tram or the train's got a working with children compliant certificate.
Typically in urban areas on public transport, they'll be secondary age students who, I'll just say, are a bit bigger and more robust and can look after themselves. But, you know, we've got about 47% of the services where there are basically no students over the age of about 12 or 13, and we've got a hold of, you know, preppies and others like that.
CCT capability, something that's part of the consideration as well. So I know, so that way, if it was required, it would have that capacity built in already.
So onboard communications, whether it be CCTV, whether it be Bluetooth sensors, whether it be passenger load counters, that is something that as a department we're doing a lot of work on.
So would you envisage, if it was possible and all the safety problems could be overcome, that it would be a sort of Mikey system of payment?
So if we did move to a sort of rollout of tap on, tap off technology, then yeah, I think that's something where we could work with transport to see if we could transition that to the Mikey system.
That concludes today's hearing. Thank you everyone for joining.